Now, I want to call these incentives carrots and sticks. Carrots are the incentives whereby if you are with the government, a lot of some of these elected members hop towards the government simply because they wanted their cases dropped, and we saw some cases withdrawn and dropped, and that is the power of the Attorney General right now. The power to start and a charge against somebody, and the power to, while the case is going on, to pull back and drop. We saw of accountability. So this is what this book is about. This book was our effort to address those problems. We commissioned researchers, experts, to look into some of the issues that we are facing by comparing them with other countries, how other countries resolve their problems, and then we make recommendations that are suitable for our country. The Brussels Steering Committee and Secretariat work closely with the authors of these research reports. Altogether, we commissioned about 19 research reports over the year, and in this book, we compiled together 16 of them, but they are not the full report. Thank you. That this allows any government form from functioning in a stable political environment and to be accountable to the rakyat. So the recommendation, representing, please read this. And the adults, the 800 over adults that are in the country, should also buy a copy so we can hit a sale of 1,000 copies, you know. And so that's the situation. So we is over there for producing this book in quick time. This book in time is literally hot off the press. This is the first time I'm holding it and looking at it. And so from 10, and you join me in counting down from 10 to 1, and then
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
we also have a chapter from Dr. Mohamad Syed Yassin, he's a university lecturer, and Sahana Katibelu. They wrote about parliamentary select committee reforms, so basically how to make our PSC having more teeth to investigate and perhaps enforce some of their reports. We also have a chapter by a team of researchers from Reform, which is an NGO, I believe, led by Iswafi Hadi Kamilan. They are talking about reintroducing the Parliamentary Services Act. So we're moving on to Fikri. Your chapter will be on public appointments and also on GLCs. Maybe we'll start by mapping out the topology of GLCs for the benefit of our audience. What are the potential problems that people have been talking about? And of course, we have been hearing people saying that politicians and elected representatives shouldn't be in GLC board at all.
It can be shunned upon because there's a conflict of interest. It can also open the door to possible, abuse of power, as we've seen in the infamous 1MDB case. But on the other hand, there's also an opinion that GLCs, they don't only serve the commercial objective, they also serve the social objective, which requires somebody who is well connected and well versed with matters of government and connecting to the rakyat and so on. So that's the debate that they should or they are permitted to be part of GLCs. So just to represent both sides of the debate, but in Malaysia's case, we have seen that appointments of political members and MPs into government-owned enterprises have been abused, especially in these recent, not only during Ismail Sabri, but also during Muhyiddin's, and also Mahathir.
Yes, this particular chapter is the shortest chapter that I contributed, and in terms of the time frame also, it was done before the Sheraton move. So it is kind of odd chapter, and if you look at it, it is called Establishing a National Address Registry with Unique Identifiers, assign the responsibility of looking at the electoral roll, how to clean it up, because at that time we were exposing all the problems that we were having with the electoral roll, and one of the main problems was the absence or the complete address of voters. There were about 50% at that time of the voters on the electoral roll that did not have an address. So if you don't have an address, how can you be certain that this person should be voting in that constituency? It's a massive problem. And we have a different way, that's the J dot whatever, or JLN dot, or spell it in two, you can spell your Taman. There's no standardized way how you name it. So what happened is that when somebody become registered as a voter in the past or eligible to vote, the election commission workers have to decide where you are staying. So they will look at the address and in their best guess, they will look at the road and then the near their best guess locality and then attach the locality to that voter. So some are people who are from probably from living in Selangor, but they have to make decision for someone over in Sabah, Sarawak or Johor, places they have no idea what it looks like, what the places are for, and they make that kind of decision.